Dear brothers and sisters, we welcome you to this Voice of Truth study series. We are continuously studying why we believe and what we believe. Today we will be studying why we believe in obedience. The world in which we live today has little respect for authority and there is so much civil disobedience. Let's see why we believe in obedience. Point 1. We believe in obedience because God requires obedience from us. In Romans chapter 11 verse 22, "Behold, therefore the goodness and severity of God on them which fell. But toward thee goodness, if thou continue in his goodness, otherwise thou also shall be cut off." Let's see few examples of the one who obeyed the Lord. In Old Testament, we can see the life of Noah. God commanded Noah to build an ark and gave all the plans for that. We can read in Genesis chapter 6 verse 22, "Thus did Noah according to all that God commanded him, so did he." Point number 2. God punishes those who disobeyed him. We can see so many examples in the whole Bible. Let's see few examples. One among them is Adam and Eve. They listened to the serpent and disobeyed God by partaking in the forbidden fruit. As a result, they died spiritually that day and were punished physically in other ways also. We read in 1 Samuel chapter 15 verse 22. "And Samuel said, Hath the Lord as great delight in burnt offerings and sacrifices as in obeying the voice of the Lord? Behold, to obey is better than sacrifice and to hearken than the fat of rams." We can see when people disobeyed Lord, they had to suffer severe consequences. In Romans chapter 15 verse 4, "For whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning, that we through patience and comfort of the scripture might have hope." Point number 3. Christ himself obeyed. Christ obeyed in all things what God said. In Hebrews chapter 5 verse 8 and 9, "Though he were a son, yet learned obedience by things which he suffered. And being made perfect, he became the author of eternal salvation unto all them that obey him." Point 4. Since Christ himself obeyed God the Father, he requires that his followers, his disciples, must obey. We read in Matthew chapter 7 verse 21, "Not everyone that said unto him, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven." We also read in Matthew 7 verse 24, "Therefore whosoever heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken him unto a wise man which built his house upon a rock." Today we have seen four points why we believe in obedience. First is, God requires obedience and reward those who obey him. Second, God punishes those who disobeyed him. Third, Christ himself obeyed God the Father. And fourth, Christ expects his disciples to obey him. So let's examine ourselves. Do we obey the Lord? If not, let us decide to obey him today. We hope this study series is useful to you. We thank you for joining us. Till we meet again, goodbye. May God bless you all.